and obviously going to be missed not only by his teammates, but by, I think, the rest of the league. It's a major loss.
When you think of the event that happened on Monday Night Football, it's something similar. And I go all the way back, you know, to Hank Gathers, which was, you know, he played for Loyola Marymount and suddenly passed away during a game on the court at the free throw line area. Boy, how many years ago was that now? But it happens.
Yes, it does.
And it's a tragedy for sure every time it does. So hearts always go out to the teammates, the coaches, the families, university,
because
it affects everybody.
No question about it. Well, let's see what happens here tonight. We've got a basketball game to watch, and hopefully the home floor will inspire our guys. They have had a little time off.
Yeah.
Whether that's good or bad, you know, the last game was on the 22nd, so that was some 2 weeks ago when the Pointers last played. So let's see what it's like here on the home floor, getting back into WIAC play. And we'll get as many scores on the women's game down in Whitewater as we can. Women are obviously with the men at home today and Saturday. The women will be on the road today and Saturday. All right, we're going to get a break for the national anthem. Not a huge crowd, unfortunately. Not like we used to get for Whitewater games. But hopefully they'll make some noise and have a reason to make some noise here today. Let's get a break for the anthem. We'll return with college basketball. This is Pointers Basketball on WPCN.
Once you realize that you're standing inside of a giant beer barrel, you'll know that this isn't just another restaurant. Now go on, open the door.
And come on into the Hilltop Pub and Grill. Grab a hot off the grill burger with dozens of topping options, steaks that always satisfy, or go for the fish fry. Now you don't have to wait till Friday, it's served every day. The Hilltop Pub and Grill has 19 beers on tap, including 13 Wisconsin brews and a menu loaded with flavor. The Hilltop Pub and Grill, just west of I-39 and Highway 10 interchange in Stevens Point.
Hey sports fans, Scott Glinski of Skyward here. From the court to the field, the ice rink to the putting green, on the track and in the classroom, Skyward supports all local and state athletes. Since 1980, our advanced technology solution has been helping school districts improve outcomes, reduce costs, and achieve success for students. Visit us online at skyward.com to learn more and see how Skyward empowers school districts across Wisconsin. Best of luck to all local sports teams this season.
The UW-Stevens Point men's basketball team is ready to take the lid off the new season with hopes of much better results. You can find out all about this year's team and what to expect on the Pointer Hoops radio show from 6 to 7 Monday night live from Monk's Bar and Grill in Plover. Sponsors include Skyward Incorporated, Hilltop Pub and Grill, Paper City Savings, The Rock and Roll Cafe, Auto Select, and Monk's Bar and Grill. Join Coach Semling and several players Monday night 6 to 7 for the Pointer Hoops radio show on WPCN. The final score, Sports Bar and Grill, where you can enjoy a sandwich and your favorite libation at the final score, where Long Island Saturdays turn into Bloody Sundays at 2nd and Maria's Stevens Point.
Welcome back out to the Quant here as we get ready for the opening tip today. Pointers will be in the home whites, and that puts the Warhawks in their road blacks somehow, even though it's supposed to be purple.
You know, we'd be remiss, Scotty, if we didn't mention the two deans of coaches.
Yeah.
In the conference squaring off, I don't know how many times they faced off, though. Pat Miller, of course, the Whitewater coach, always one of our favorites. 419 victories for Pat over his career. Bob started as the head coach here a little later. He has 330 victories. This is interesting. Pat Miller's winning percentage, 72.1. Coach Semling's winning percentage, 71.9. So. 0.2%.
Yeah, two really good coaches, to say the least.
Yeah.
And both, you know, trying to get back to the top of the conference, quite honestly.
Yeah. How many years, Scotty, was this the game that might have determined the conference champion? But not recently. No.
That's a fact. All right, starting lineups here for the Pointers and the Warhawks. And they are going to go with a group, but Whitewater is. 6'2 sophomore Jameer Barker out of Racine St. Catherine. 6'2 freshman Miles Barnstable from Sheboygan and Howard's Grove High. 6'4 junior Delvin Barnstable from Sheboygan and Sheboygan Lutheran High School. 6'5 sophomore Carter Capstrand from Franklin and 6'6 junior Trayvon Chisholm from McFarland. For our pointers, it'll be 6'2 senior Zach Moots out of Merrill, 6' junior Jake Buchanan from Kimberly, 6' junior A.J. Mackinnon from Waterford and Muskego High School, 6'5 sophomore Brennan Tim out of West Bend West High School, and the fifth starter here for the pointers this evening is going to be 6'8 junior Elijah Vandervelden out of Huntington, Illinois.
Scotty, Whitewater has two players from Racine St. Catharines, Lambert and Barker, and of course they were both coached by our favorite son, Nick Bennett.
Yep, that'd be a fact. All right, here we go, opening tip controlled by the Warhawks. It is Barnstable, the freshman, into the front court against Mackinnon. Handoff pass tipped away, picked up by Buchanan. Two on one to the other end. He'll get it over to Brennan Tim. And the pointers score the first two. Nice
well, deep. When you turn it over up on top, it usually results to two on the other end.
Barker into the front court. This one tipped away, but Barnstable, Delvin, got it back this time. Sends it over to Miles. Out on top, it'll go to Chisholm to the free throw line. Turnaround jump shot rolls off the rim. Elijah with a rebound out to Mackinnon. Up it'll come, Stevens Point across the timeline. Mackinnon heads left. Holds it there against Barnstable. Across the way, it'll go to Brennan Tim. Quickly left side, Mackinnon to the free throw line. Tim into the corner, it'll go to Buchanan. We're just a minute into the ball game from the right corner. Brennan Tim strokes a three and hits it.
We had a ball screen on the right wing. Both defenders went with the ball handler. And Tim just rolled to an open spot.
Early 5-0. Chisholm to a cutting Barker, got by Buchanan, an easy layup.
He's a nice size for a guard. They list him at 6 foot. He seems bigger than that to me.
18:40 to go, 5-2 pointer lead. Moots had it tipped away by Barnstable, but Zach got it back. Over to Buchanan, right wing, back over to Moots, had a little trouble with it. Kick out to the right corner. This time Tim's short, but he gets his own board. Takes it back up inside, overlays. Elijah boards it. Off it'll go there to Moots. Pulls up from 14, in and out, no. Rebound tipped around, finally picked out of there by Barnstable.
Well, two good chances, couldn't get it to go down.
Chisholm left side, quickly over to the corner, Barnstable. Delvin on the drive into the lane, got to the rack and scores.
And that's the defensive area, Scotty, that we struggle. And notice the penetration all the way from the corner right to the rim.
A.J. Mackinnon left side down to the baseline, and he is fouled there. That one is going to go on Miles Barnstable.
Yep, got the bump. Well, both teams man-to-man, which is kind of what you might expect. Over the years, we've certainly seen Pat Miller use different kinds of defenses, and that includes full court at times. So if he changes up here, wouldn't be a surprise at some point.
Inbound left baseline, catch and shoot. Buchanan rolls off the rim. Chisholm with a rebound.
Jake, a streaky shooter. If he gets on a roll, he can light you up.
Barker up top, over to the left corner, falls
big
down.
Bump.
Where are we going to get the foul call? Looks like it'll be on Moots.
Yeah, big hard fall by Barker. And he went flying out of bounds, actually. So I think that was probably a good call.
Instead, it was on Buchanan.
Three. Yeah, Jake Buchanan.
So he's got to come out. That's the system here. Ryan Genrick will come
you know
in.
And he's a little dinged up on that contact.
Yep. Barnstable to inbound, gets it to Barker in the left corner. Pointers had an early 5-0 lead. Whitewater looking for the lead right here. Barker's three ball off the rim, rebound Brennan Tim. Outlet and on ahead comes Stevens Point. Mackinnon over to left side, Moots asking for it, but then wasn't ready to catch a pass.
Oh boy.
This one tipped away, Barnstable on the break to the other end, takes it in against Genrick,
yeah,
under legs, we'll get a block.
Yeah, no doubt that was a block. He moved under him and then just kind of leaned with him.
Not sure what's going on with the ball handling there, but that was just a bad play on the part of the pointers.
Just sloppy.
Miles Coleman getting set to come in here now. That's the first one on Genrick. Free throw short by Barnstable.
Chance to tie it up here.
Yep, second chance. Miles Barnstable, I guess the older brother Delvin had been at Marion College, and when Whitewater recruited Miles, he brought his older brother with him, so they got two starters in one, so to say.
Not a bad deal.
No.
Too bad they're not triplets.
Five apiece. After the second free throw, good by Barnstable. Mackinnon on the dribble into the lane, kicks it out to Coleman. Back out to Ryan Genrich. Now you have a squad on the floor where you just wonder, where's the scoring going to come from, in all honesty. Tried to shovel a pass over to Vander Belden. Instead, Whitewater gets it, goes to the other end, and another foul on Stevens Point.
Yep, Whitewater taking the ball and flying with it. If you don't run transition tonight, you're going to be in trouble. That was a nice outlet pass. Good job of running the floor by the Warhawks.
Well, you got in deep, and instead of taking a shot, you tried to throw a pass down at the knees of a 6'8 guy. That never worked.
I don't know what Ryan was thinking. I thought he had the reverse layup. You know, we used a rim as a protector. I thought that shot was available to him. And frankly, I was watching his eyes, and he never looked at that shot. I don't think there was ever any intention as he went across the baseline to that reverse to shoot.
Foul on Tim, that'll bring Moots back in. Chisholm makes both, and the pointers trail for the first time at 7-5.
If you shoot that shot, Scotty, two good things can happen and only one bad. You can make it, you get fouled, or you might miss it, or might get it blocked.
Yeah. Coleman to the elbow, long cross court, Moots to the lane, kicks it out there, Genrich down to the corner, Miles trying to work baseline against Barnstable. Got inside, fadeaway jumper, got it.
Boy, step back jumper, that's a tough shot.
That's something Miles can bring to this team if he figures it out on the defensive end and plays within the offensive system. He'll get more and more playing time. We're tied at 7.
Turns it over a little too much.
Yep. Oh, Elijah, good defense, tipped it away inside, trying to get it in there that time to Capstrand.
But as you know, I like Miles Coleman a good deal, to transfer from Bethel. 6'3 out of South Milwaukee and Brookfield Central.
Gives you athleticism and a little more side. Capstrand against Elijah, got in, blocked partially by Genrich, but he still got it to go.
Strong post move.
9-7 Warhawks, Coleman front court. Off the Moot screen, left side back to Zach. Looks, goes across the way. Mackinnon wants a triple, rims out long. Whitewater will get the board. Barnstable, front court, top of the circle, into the lane, tipped away, picked up by Moots. On ahead, it'll go to Coleman.
Oh,
he has it
hands.
Tipped away by Barker on the way down. Didn't know he was there. On ahead, left corner, Barnstable to the rack, and he'll score that one.
Yes, Sam. Somehow he had Elijah Vanderveld, and, you know, in the transition defense in the corner. Good recognition that I've got a mismatch. You can't stay with me. And all the way to the rim he went.
11-7 Warhawks. Genrich trying to split the defense, got to the baseline, nowhere to go. Curls back out to the corner, off to Mackinnon, send it right to Coleman. Moots a deep three, got one.
Well, we're down one. But notice how much harder we're working for our shots right now and how they're scoring in the paint.
Barnstable, handoff, Barnstable against Miles Coleman. Wanted to go to Barker, had it tipped away, got it back. Now it goes to Barker out between the circles. 11-10 Warhawks, early going here. Barker over the top of the circle with a dribble against AJ into the corner. Barnstable lifts the three off the rim. Long rebound, Mackinnon. He'll break it out, two on two. He'll wait for teammates. Inside the arc, gives back to Elijah. Over to Coleman, gets a step. Thought he could have gone right to the rack.
He could have. That was a left-hand layup.
Decided not to. He didn't want to challenge the big guy.
He saw the big help coming, but I would have liked to see an explosion to the rim, left-hand finish.
Go in, use that left-hand finish, and I think you either get two or maybe go to the line. Barker from the left wing will hit a three.
Yeah, the lefty.
Confidence, big part of the game.
Yep.
Ryan Genrich into the front court, 14-16 to go. Reaching
foul. And we're not attacking, Scotty. We're passive.
Yep, Genrich inside, Elijah left-hander, no, rebound Chisholm. That's where you got to score. You got it all the way down there, you've got to score that. 14-10 Whitewater, Barker down the lane, kicks to the corner, wide open three, Barnstable, no. Genrich with the rebound. Ryan will start it up the floor for Stevens Point, Buchanan. Warden getting set to come in. Right wing, it'll go there, underneath, A.J. Mackinnon curls back out of the land of the Giants, gives it off there. Moots wants another triple, rattles out, no. Good. Rebound, Barnstable.
Good closeout that time by Barnstable.
Delvin down the lane, blocked off there, got it to Chisholm on the wing. Chisholm gets it right back, tipped away by Mackinnon, picked up by Barnstable, right back underneath. I thought for a moment he missed it. Chisholm rolled it in.
Yeah, 50-50 ball that we did not get. It turns to two.
6-point lead for Whitewater. 13-17 to go here. Coleman, top of the circle. Working on the dribble, into the lane, down the lane, got in deep, should, oh, and he missed the layup. Yeah. I was just gonna say, should score that, and he blew the layup.
Yeah, the ball fell down onto the palm of his hands. It didn't get up on the fingers.
Barnstable gives back on the wing. Barnstable with it. Miles along the wing, gives to the corner, now gets it back, drives inside. It's an 8-point difference. Almost need a timeout.
Yeah, I'm thinking so. Our interior defense is letting us down.
And you're not scoring at the other end. Yep. Henrik, a long cross court to Moots.
Yeah, 18 already we've given up with 12:36 to go.
Moots, big collision there, and a blocking foul on Chisholm. That'll be a chance at least to get these other guys in. Buchanan and Luke Warden will come into the ball game for Stevens Point. You sure can't afford to get too far behind here.
No.
This is going to be your first time out of the game. 12:34 to go. Let's take the minute break. We'll come right back. Pointers basketball on WPCN.
Eat like a rock star at the Rock and Roll Cafe. They have something for all ages. Seniors enjoy a special menu including salads, pasta, and sandwiches, all at a reasonable price. For the little Rock and Roll Cafe stars, get a free drink and ice cream for breakfast and lunch. Bring your taste buds for a firecracker burger, a quarter pound beef with pepper jack cheese, lettuce, and tomato with a garnish of crispy corn tortilla strips and jalapeno ranch. Rock and Roll Cafe, located at 2801 Stanley Street, where you're always treated like a rock star. Open daily 7 to 3. Auto Select is your dependable auto repair and service destination with qualified technicians you know you can trust. Schedule an appointment or stop in to visit them at one of their two Stevens Point locations on Highway 10 East and on Church Street. Whether it's a nail in your tire, noise under the hood, or just an oil change, Auto Select gets you back on the road. Good luck to the UWSP Pointers this season from Auto Select. Quality, dependable auto repair and service performed by qualified technicians you can trust.
12:34 to go here in half number one. Whitewater out to a 8-point lead at 18-10.
Scotty, Pointers 4-13 to start this game. That's 30%. Whitewater, 7-11. 63% points in the paint. 12-2. Hence the 63% shooting. But points in the paint has just been a storyline for this team for 2 years.
Yep. Nobody wants to defend. And you got to stop the ball from getting in there first. Over to the right wing, it'll go to Buchanan, and along the right baseline, Moots. Sack trying to go baseline, sneaks in, kicks to the corner, tipped away. It'll be off of Coleman, or no, sorry about that, off of Whitewater's Lambert and out of bounds.
And Scotty, that defense starts with on-ball defense and not chasing, not letting your opponent get downhill, which is what we've seen early so far.
Coleman inbounds, Buchanan tries to go reverse, missed the shot. Luke Warden underneath, double clutches, overlays, rebound, Lambert. Well, he finally got inside. You've missed three layups already now. Up front, it'll come Hoytink into the ball game. Into the left corner, down low, it'll go to Chisholm, backing in against the freshman Warden. Fadeaway jumper, left it short. Tipped up, Miles Coleman rebound.
That was good defense right there by the freshman.
Need a basket, 18-10 is your score. Coleman on the wing, off the Warden screen, all the way to the corner. Miles to the free throw line, to a backdoor cutting Jake Buchanan. He's got his first two.
Yep, Jake always moving, that time on a back cut. Good find, good assist.
18-12, Warhawks, right wing. This time into the hands of Drew Fisher into the ball game. Fisher bounces it off up high, Chisholm down the lane, and we're gonna get a foul.
And they're gonna get a shooting foul. Well, Luke Ward, the freshman, got over a little too high on that left shoulder, a little too much overplay up in the three-point line, and he gave up a drive to the basket with the overplay. Chisholm, give him credit, he saw that opportunity and just left him behind.
Chisholm averages 15.4. He already has five in the ball game. 19-12 is your score.
Mitch
Chisholm
Farland,
will get another one.
Home of Shirley Egner.
Got him both.
I believe that's the home of Matt Hockett, too. Did he play?
I believe he said that, yeah.
I think both Shirley, interestingly enough, both of our women's coaches, back-to-back, came from McFarland.
Yep. Genrich into the front court. Again, an 8-point difference. Ryan all the way to the baseline, tosses up on top, over to the wing. It'll go there to Mackinnon. A.J. on the dribble into the lane, down the lane. Jump stop, short little turnaround. Got it, beauty.
Got him going momentum-wise. Gave a ball fake, and the defender just went right by.
20-14. Get some stops here. Up on top.
And a foul.
And a hand check foul on Buchanan. Didn't move the feet quick enough.
Yeah,
that's his second. He'll have to sit.
Yeah, and that's 11 minutes to go. And you're going to lose your best player.
That's going to bring in Shane Tarjan, the freshman out of Niles, Illinois.
So you're going to play without Buchanan, your playmaker, for 11 minutes.
Yeah. Inbound, it'll come. Whitewater with the basketball. Again, Shane into the lane. It looked underneath. Nice job by Shane to cut him off that time. Quite think I'm talking about. Barker sends it over to the right side, down into the corner. It'll go to Fisher. Back on top, Barker against Mackinnon. Free throw line. Over to the right side. Hoyting fakes it, takes it into the lane, down the lane. Missed the layup, but the Pointers don't get the rebound. It goes off the bottom of the backboard. They get it back again and score it. There is just no defense inside.
And, of course, your defensive stand doesn't end until you get the rebound.
Out on the wing, Tarjan. Over to the right side, Genrich. Top of the circle with a dribble. Crossover, kicks it out to Mackinnon. Mackinnon over Warden's screen, launches the trip and hits it. A.J. having a heck of a season.
Yeah, Pointers playing small here.
Five. Made a lot of mistakes, but you're only down five.
Yep.
Barker with it in the front court for Whitewater. Stepping up, takes the high screen from Capstrand into the corner. It'll go. Working around Hoytink, over to the left side. Fisher into the lane, a little bump from Genrich down the lane, puts it off the glass and scores it again.
You know, that's a physical mismatch. Once Hoytink was able to get in Fisher. Into the paint, Fisher, excuse me, we just couldn't match up with the size.
Over to the right side, down to the corner, it'll go to Ryan Genrich. Genrich, free throw line, kick out, Tarjan takes it to the line again, kicks it over to Genrich. Shot clock 9 now. Boots into the lane, tough pass underneath, connects with Warden, missed it, got it back, goes up, and he'll
nice
score
job.
It.
Well, stuck with it. Missed it the first time, stuck with it, and got it on try number 2. Good effort.
19, Lambert, left corner with a dribble. Takes it into the lane, nice spin move, block, and they're going to get him for a travel.
Yep.
All right. Paper City Savings, proud supporter of our community with locations in Plover, Wisconsin, Rapids, and in Nakusa. 9:08 to go, 5-point Whitewater lead.
Elijah Lambert looked at the official as if, don't you watch the NBA? That's a typical spin move.
Yeah.
Typical spin move at Division I, too, probably.
Mackinnon hurries it into the front court, gives it off to Moots. Zach picked up the dribble, then finds a little help from Shane Tarjan over to the left side, now to AJ. Off the Brennan Tim screen, into the lane. Kicks to the right side. Moots for three, and he hits another one. Zach with two. Pointers back within two.
We're hanging in there behind the three ball right now.
Right side, Whitewater with it. Fisher, guarded there by Genrich. Tosses up to Chisholm, over to Lambert on the wing. Free throw line extended left. Chisholm at the line, trying to take Tim down low. Puts up a tough shot. No, tipped up and in.
Yeah, above
just
everybody.
Too many second chances.
And Trevon was just above. He just was a foot above everybody, almost tipped that straight down.
It's not fair.
doesn't seem to be when you're my size.
Yeah. Long skip pass. Mooch wants another triple, and he's fouled on a three ball from way outside.
Yeah, that was NBA three.
Or beyond.
Got bailed out a little
bit. That was Steph Curry three for Pete's
But you
sake.
Know, after you've hit a few threes in a row, then the defense gets a little bit more concerted in trying to close out. They're just too aggressive that time.
Foul on
by
Fisher.
Drew Fisher.
And Moots misses the first. Final score, Sports Bar and Grill scoreboard right now shows Stevens Point trailing 26-22. Plan your before or after game get-togethers at the final score, second of Maria Stevens Point.
Zach's 73% free throw shooter. And you know what, actually, Scotty, neither one of those was particularly close.
No. Missed the first two. That kills you.
Yeah. I mean, you work so hard, they make the mistake, and you come out with 1 point. Better one than none, but you needed all of them.
26-23. Well, it's early in the game.
Yep.
He'll make them down the stretch if we get a chance. Barnstable on the left wing, off the dribble, working against Genrich, out high to Lambert. Chisholm trying to post up against Tim down there. Barker, Lambert, free throw line, backs it out against Zach, takes it down the lane, goes up strong, no, Chisholm again over the top, no. Rebound Barnstable, and he got that one.
Well, give Chisholm.
He's getting pushed way under the basket.
Give Chisholm the credit for that basket. He got the tip, and once he got that tip, they got better position, and we just couldn't recover.
Our smaller, thin guys get pushed right under the basket.
Yeah, we just could not get off the floor with them either.
28-23. Genrich into the lane, down the lane. Nice leave off to Brennan. Tim, he'll go up. No, but good a foul.
Well, he got to the line. I would have liked to have seen him go right up with
it. I agree. That's second on Chisholm for what it's worth.
Another play that could have worked there, Scotty, is he was rolling to the basket. They could have just lobbed that up to the front of the rim, and he just could have caught, and dropped it over. But we'll take the foul.
Yep. 7:16 to go. Timeout. Whitewater 28, Pointers 23, back in a minute. UW-Stevens Point men's basketball on WPCN.
Once you realize that you're standing inside of a giant beer barrel, you'll know that this isn't just another restaurant. Now go on, open the door.
And come on into the Hilltop Pub and Grill. Grab a hot off the grill burger with dozens of topping options, steaks that always satisfy, or go for the fish fry. Now you don't have to wait till Friday, it's served every day. The Hilltop Pub and Grill has 19 beers on tap, including 13 Wisconsin brews and a menu loaded with flavor. The Hilltop Pub and Grill, just west of I-39 and Highway 10 interchange in Stevens Point.
An engagement ring is the defining symbol of a lifelong promise, and that's why choosing Lee Ayers Jewelers is so important. As a family business, they know how important your search is, and they take great pride in helping you find the perfect engagement ring. For Lee Ayers, it's all about taking care of you, the customer. From in-store goldsmiths to custom jewelry design by Thomas Dayling, they do it all. Begin your lifelong promise by choosing Lee Ayers Jewelers, downtown Stevens Point.
Pointers fans, head over to the Final Score Sports Bar and Grill before or after the game for your get-togethers. The Final Score, second in Maria Stevens Point.
All right, 7:16 to go. Pointers are down by five right now, John.
Whitewater able to grab five offensive rebounds. The last two possessions have both been by Chisholm. And those offensive boards have converted to 6 points. We've been outscored second chance points, 6-2. And there's another missed free throw, Scotty.
Shoot yourself in the foot when you can't make a free throw.
We're now 1 of 4. Pointers shoot 76% as a team.
That one out of the two. Brennan has 6 points early. By the way, all the other games, of course, underway. Lacrosse trailing Platteville 20-13. River Falls up on Stout 22-15. Eau Claire 17, Oshkosh 10. Barnstable over the top of the circle, down to the baseline, threw it at the basket. Nice D by Shane Tarjan, rebounded by Josiah Gilley. On ahead, it'll go Miles Coleman, lifts the jumper, rattles off, no. A quick shot, you didn't have enough help down there. Up it'll come again, Barker to the top of the circle. Kicks it out there, on the runner down the lane. Whiting to the corner, Barnstable for three, off the rim. Tarjan with a rebound. Shane doing a nice job here. Not known for offense, and he's going to have to improve that to get himself more playing time. Moots with it between the circles, over to Tarjan on the right side. Shane works dribble here, and in place of Buchanan, out with two fouls already. Miles Coleman, we're going to get a screening foul,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, it's Josiah. Going to be Josiah. The obligatory free throw line extended foul, boy. You see a couple of those every game. Here's our first.
6:28 to go, still a 4-point lead for Whitewater.
And of course, with motion offenses nowadays, they have to call that foul. Otherwise, it'd be virtually impossible if you allow all those moving screens.
Whiting, left side, Barnstable. This is Delvin with it. Back to Whiting, into the lane, down the lane against AJ. Kicks it out, Barnstable gets into the lane, jump stop, spin move. How is that not traveling?
He got blocked. But Miles got a piece of that on the way up.
Well, he got blocked, and then he got two.
You know, we offered some help initially on that matchup, Scotty, and then we left that help in the paint to go over to run the shooters in the corner, and he got the two.
Moots off the left wing, down to the baseline. Wanted to make a move. He got cut off nicely there. Back out it'll come. Long cross court, eight on the shot clock. Miles Coleman by his man down the lane should score it, and he's got the layup.
Little body contact, though, but I think Miles maybe kind of initiated that. Good no call.
So 30-26, Whitewater. Hoy Tink over the top of the circle. Gives back Barnstable. Left wing. Looking in, going into the post this time, trying to back his way in.
Boy, travel.
That's traveling.
Yep. He's trying to set himself up for the drop step. He's going to work off his left shoulder and just kind of lost his balance.
We'll see if he can come down and get a little bit closer. Skyward Incorporated, connecting parents and education. Pointers down by four.
You're going to be a post player, young guys at home. Footwork, 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 right?
Yep, that's for sure. Mackinnon across the timeline. Working at four, Stevens Point. Genrich getting set to come back. Tarjan on the right side. Shane to the top of the circle. Goes through the lane. Comes back right side. Kicks it out to Coleman. Miles working on the dribble there. Takes it to the lane. Fadeaway jumper. Got one again.
Yeah, little intermediary jump shot. Miles has hit a couple of them. Good one-on-one move.
30-28, Whitewater. Left side, it'll go to Barker up on top. Poitink. Top of the circle, going to lift the three off the rim. Coleman with a rebound.
Now, A.J. fell down, gave the open three. Fortunately, they just missed it.
Coleman across the timeline. Working left wing, looking at Gilly down in the post. Sends it back instead to Mackinnon. Out on top, it'll go Zach Moots, who has hit a couple of threes. Tarjan left side, Mackinnon looking at Gilly. Drops it in on the left block. Josiah working against Capstrand. Spin move, goes up, blocked away, out of bounds. Pointer basketball.
Six on the shot clock, so we won't have a lot of time here. You get a catch, dribble, and a pass out of this. See what we set up off the inbounds.
Josiah back out. Elijah will come in. 30-28, Warhawks. As John said, six on the shot clock, so you're going to have to, you don't have to rush, but you have to be aware you don't have all day to get a shot off. Inbound, Mackinnon left corner, launches the three, rolls it off the rim.
Would have given their pointers the lead.
Yep.
We haven't had that since five. We were led 5-4.
Yeah, that's right. I think 7-5 they went off, and that's the last time. It'll come over to the right side. Whitewater working down to the baseline. Something's going on out there. I have no idea what. Can't see half the court.
It's going to be a foul on Miles Coleman, and it's going to be team foul number 7. So, Carter Capstrand from Franklin is going to go to the line.
As John said on Coleman, so he has to sit now.
Warhawks, 3:58 to go, Scotty. They have just 4 fouls.
Yeah.
We won't shoot.
Well, we don't attack the basket.
Nope, there's a difference.
Capstrand will get 2 here. Free throw, bounces around and drops in. It would be really nice to see the game sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, we're right down here on the floor. We have the worst view of anybody in the place.
Second one misses. Moots with a rebound.
Capstrand, a 54% free throw shooter. Just about on his average there.
Moots into the front court, handoff to Mackinnon, and almost fumbled that away. AJ comes left side to Tim. Brennan against Lambert, back into the hands of Mackinnon. 3:40 to go in the half. Into the corner, here comes the double team, got rid of it. Genrich over to the right side, moots up the Elijah Vanderbilt screen, pull up jumper, got,
well,
2.
Leaned into the defender, and was able to step back. We're shooting pretty well since the 10-minute mark.
Whitewater with a 1-point lead. Left wing with it is Lambert against Tim. Passes on top, Capstrand over to the right side. Into the lane, Fisher down the lane, missed the shot. Tim with a rebound.
Well, chance fortunate to lead. There. Fisher just blew by Moots.
Zach into the front court, working between the circles. Left side, Mackinnon off the screen from Tim. Kind of a moving, well, rolling screen. Back to AJ, wants a triple, that's offline. Rebound into the hands of Whitewater. Yeah. Don't know that was a good three by AJ.
Little two-man basketball on the left side, and he launched a pretty tough three.
Fisher, Barnstable. Kick out, he's Barker, got, and an offensive foul.
Oh.
On.
I'm gonna say an illegal screen.
Yeah, illegal screen, offensive foul on Barnstable. That's his second now.
At first when that whistle came, Sky, I thought they were going to get Jameer Barker on that hop to set up for the three.
Travel.
Yeah, and maybe call the travel as he was setting his feet for a three. But it turned out they saw something I did not see.
Another chance to get a lead here. Ryan Genrich with it. Right side, right through the hands of Mackinnon.
Ouch.
Unbelievable. Off it'll go, left wing to the rack, score the layup for Fisher.
Boy, you got a chance to get your lead and you turn over on a very simple play.
Genrich underneath to Elijah, lost it going up, we've got a foul. Just one should be nice to finish and get an and one.
Yeah.
Capstrand with the foul.
Elijah just once and you'd be satisfied, Mr. Krieger?
Well, that would be a start.
Well, that would be a start. You can't have two until you have one.
Yeah, that's
see, I was a math major in college, so.
Paying off.
Yeah.
Elijah makes the first, he'll get another one. Well, I know there's still 2:20 to go, so anything can happen, but if you get out of here with roughly, you know, a 1-2 point deficit as Elijah
well,
makes
the keep in
both.
Mind, we've been Buchanan's playing without Buchanan since the 11:59 mark.
Yep. So 1 point ball game.
And we were down six at that moment.
Barker over the top of the circle with the dribble. Sends it left. Hoytink wants three. Brackets out. No deep rebound. Capstrand in the corner.
Out of bounds.
And he stepped on the baseline. Or the end
not line. Much you can do with that rebound. I mean, they just those threes sometimes really careen off of there. And that one went right out of bounds on the left corner.
That is a fact. El Mezcal Restaurant out on Highway 10 East, Stevens Point. Check out El Mezcal on Facebook for all their specials. El Mezcal, Stevens Point.
Well, it's been a good game, Scotty. Yeah. Both teams playing pretty well.
Fighting hard.
Yep.
33-32 Whitewater, point with a basketball. Mackinnon off the Vanderbilt screen. Sends it right to Genrich. Into the corner, it'll go to Moots. Down deeper, it'll go to Brennan Tim. Working against Lambert in the post, trying to get inside. Lambert holding him off, and we're finally going to get the foul.
Boy, that was a battle, wasn't it?
Yeah. Lambert just stronger, and Brennan was trying to back his way in like you see all those big guys do. Yeah. He couldn't move him.
Brennan says, I'm going in. I'm going. Lambert says, no, you're not. That was would have been a classic one-on-one in your backyard.
Brennan, front
no,
end of a one-on-one.
No officials on those who just beat on each other until somebody gave up.
First one by Brennan is good. We're back tied.
Kind of a flat free throw, but down it went.
33 apiece. Can he give the Pointers the lead here with a minute 47 to go? It's on the way, and the Pointers regain the lead at 34-33.
It's been a long while. Give the Pointers a lot of credit, Scotty. They were
absolutely
struggling in the middle of this half, and they pulled themselves together. Partly because
they're eight.
Partly because they're shooting such a better percentage right now.
Hoytink, Lambert in the corner. Back it will go to Hoytink, trying to get down the baseline, cut off by Mackinnon. Looking for help, finds Barker on the wing. Barker kicks it out, Hoytink, top of the circle, free throw line. Picks up, gives it back to Barker. Barker against Tarjan. Got by Shane, down the lane, underneath
the
goal. Blocked by Genrich. Loose ball underneath. Whitewater gets it back, puts it up, no. Rebound, Whitewater again, up and good.
Strength inside.
What a great block. Will Pitleski ends up with a basket, 35-34.
Couldn't get a handle on that ball after it got blocked.
Genrich, crossover dribble, picked up after not finding what he wanted. Tarjan on the left baseline. Shane brings it back out. Works dribble into the lane, kick out. Moots, no shot available. Eight on the shot clock, into the lane, and a foul on Barker.
I think so. That's where it's coming. Ball kind of got stuck on the left wing there for the longest time. Shot clock started winding down. Fortunate to get to a foul as we were getting to the end of that shot clock.
So Moots will go to the line with another 1-1 here for the Pointers.
Not sure Pat Miller agrees with how that was called. No, but over the years, Pat has disagreed on more than one occasion. Fiery guy.
Yeah.
Loves the game of golf, by the way, so.
And a good golfer.
Yeah, a very good golfer. You know, him and Coach Bennett, Jack, good buddies. I don't know if people always knew that as they coached against each other.
35-34, Warhawks. Moots, front end of a 1-1, got the first. Ties it back up. He'll get the second to try to give the Pointers lead. Inside a minute to go here in the opening half. Monk's Bar and Grill, Wisconsin grown, Wisconsin proud. Monk's Bar and Grill, proud supporter of UW Stevens Point basketball, and he missed the second. We're tied at 35. Zach having a bad night at the line.
Yeah, some of those are just not close.
Yep. Pitleski with it, gives it off left wing. Fisher on top, Hoytink over the top of the circle, free throw line down the left of the lane, poked away by Genrich, but he got it back. Hoytink outside, Barker. Barker against Tarjan. 25 seconds to go. 7 on the shot clock.
Oh, working beautiful.
The dribble into the lane, down the lane, stripped away. Who's going to get it? Lambert at the horn will put it up.
Right at the shot clock. That was a desperation shot as much as anything. We'll go for one here.
There's a foul that didn't get fouled there on Barker. Moots into the lane, kicks to the corner. Tarjan, 6 seconds to go. Who's going to get the shot? Ryan Genrich, 3 seconds. Got to get something up. He'll launch on the way, rolls around, and just off the rim, no. And we will head to the locker room. Whitewater will have the 2-point lead. Warhawks 37, Stevens Point 35. We'll come back here in 90 seconds. UW-Stevens Point men's basketball on WPCN.
At El Mezcal Stevens Point, every day is a special day. The margaritas, best in town. On Tuesday and Thursday, 2-for-1 all day long. Any size and any flavor, and that's when the fun begins. Authentic Mexican food is made mild, but you can have it your way. Mild, medium, or spicy for a kicker. Come see the new restaurant that is located across from the old location next to Highway 10. Open 7 days a week at 11 a.m. They have inside dining, heated patio, or pickup. Come enjoy the inviting atmosphere. El Mezcal, authentic Mexican restaurant. Check out Facebook for more specials.
Hey sports fans, Scott Glinski of Skyward here. From the court to the field, the ice rink to the putting green, on the track and in the classroom, Skyward supports all local and state athletes. Since 1980, our advanced technology solution has been helping school districts improve outcomes, reduce costs, and achieve success for students. Visit us online at skyward.com to learn more and see how Skyward empowers school districts across Wisconsin. Best of luck to all local sports teams this season.
Auto Select is your dependable auto repair and service destination with qualified technicians you know you can trust. Schedule an appointment or stop in to visit them at one of their 2 Stevens Point locations on Highway 10 East and on Church Street. Whether it's a nail in your tire, noise under the hood, or just an oil change, Auto Select gets you back on the road. Good luck to the UWSP Pointers this season from Auto Select. Quality, dependable auto repair and service performed by qualified technicians you can trust.
Monk's Bar and Grill, Wisconsin grown, Wisconsin proud. Monk's Bar and Grill is a proud supporter of UW-Stevens Point basketball, located at Crossroad Commons, Plover.
Well, it's halftime here at the Quant, and Whitewater with a 2-point lead at 37-35. Pointers give credit to Ryan. At least he got a shot up, and it rolled around and just didn't want to drop. But you had to fight so hard just to get a shot off there at the end. And, of course, the shot by Lambert to get the lead. You had how many cracks at getting a rebound, picking up a loose ball. Lambert gets it. It's just the way the first half went.
Well, Scotty, I tell you what, I'm feeling a little bit relieved, I suppose, to get to the locker room just down 2, 37-35. When I look at the points in the paint, we've been outscored 28-12. A lot of times when you see that kind of a stat, you start to think, boy, you're in trouble. So right now, Whitewater doing it inside, Stevens Point doing it by way of the jump shot. Early on in this game, Whitewater was shooting at a 63% clip. They've dropped down to 46%. So give the Pointers credit. They were in a little bit of trouble, I thought, in the mid part. And then your captain, your playmaker, goes to the bench with 2 fouls at 10:59. And the guys, including the bench, really fought back hard to get this game down 2. And how many times did we have opportunities to actually take the lead in the first half? And on a possession, we'd missed maybe a couple free throws or miss an open... Or turn the ball over a couple of times and never even get a shot. But that's the game of basketball. It's certainly not a game of perfect. And both teams, I thought, played at a pretty high level.
Yeah. No, I'll take this. And to only be down by 2 with Buchanan sitting for, well, not only the final 11 minutes, but he sat part of the 8-9 minutes before that.
Yeah, he played a total of 3 minutes, 52 seconds.
Yeah, your leading scorer.
Yeah, so... I would think in the locker room, the coaching staff and team is feeling pretty good about their situation.
Yeah, I'm going to go with you there. 37-35 is your score. We'll check on some other scores around the league in a moment, including how our women's basketball team is doing down in Whitewater. We will be right back here on Saturday, by the way, as the Pointer men will be hosting lacrosse. Now, keep in mind, that is a 5 o'clock start coming up on Saturday. All right, 5 o'clock game on Saturday. So if you are going to participate in that one, make sure that you get here on time and watch our pointers as they hopefully will be going for a second straight conference win. I guess I should get the first one in the book before I start talking about a second one, huh, John?
There
coaches don't like that. I'm not coaching, so it doesn't really matter that
well,
much.
Well, we've tried to coach many times over the
That's what we're told.
100 years. We've tried to officiate, we've tried to coach, and yet I haven't received a paycheck for doing either one.
You're right, and where is that paycheck?
Well,
if they're claiming we are, then we ought to get something.
Our paycheck, Scotty, is just satisfaction and knowing that we were right.
There you go. I'll go with that. I will go with that. It is almost halftime down in Whitewater, and the Pointer women have a one-point lead there.
Oh.
So we'll watch that.
Two great games.
Yeah, really. That's a tough one. Talked to Coach Hockett this morning on the air, and he's fired up. And I'll tell you what, if you are a fan of Pointer women's basketball, we have a nice team right now. Everybody will be back next year, and Coach is bringing in a recruiting class.
Yeah.
He just got another commitment, and he was telling me, I hope it's, well, he said it on the air, so what the heck. He thinks the best shooter in the state of Wisconsin is going to come here.
Yeah, Division I athlete.
Well, non-Division I.
But she was going to be, I believe, and as I understand, if you're, we're talking about the same girl, soon to be considered a woman once you get to college, she was being courted by a Division I team, and everybody left her alone, and suddenly that team disappeared, and guess who was left standing but our Pointers? And then I believe he's got a young lady coming in from Duluth.
Yep, he got a girl from Duluth, yeah, South Shore.
Matt's got a great connection in Duluth, of course. He was a heck of a basketball player for UMD, an assistant coach at UMD before he came here to Point. So I tell you this. He's working his tail off, and it all starts with recruiting.
Yeah.
You know, let's face it, it's about talent. I mean, coaches, obviously, definitely make a difference, right? But you've got to have some talent, and I don't care how good the coach is, talent wins
most of
the time.
Halftime right now, Whitewater leads 37-35 over our Pointer men. Let's take a one-minute break. We'll come back. John will have all the stats from half number one. This is UW-Stevens Point basketball on WPCN.
Once you realize that you're standing inside of a giant beer barrel, you'll know that this isn't just another restaurant. Now go on, open the door. And come on into the Hilltop Pub and Grill. Grab a hot-off-the-grill burger with dozens of topping options. Steaks that always satisfy, or go for the fish fry. Now, you don't have to wait till Friday. It's served every day. The Hilltop Pub and Grill has 19 beers on tap, including 13 Wisconsin brews and a menu loaded with flavor. The Hilltop Pub and Grill, just west of I-39 and Highway 10 Interchange in Stevens Point.
Are you ready to own your own home? Then Paper City Savings is a place to go. We provide the convenience of applying in person or online, and our friendly home loan professionals will help you every step of the way. If owning a home is in your future, contact Paper City Savings today. Locations in Plover, Wisconsin Rapids, and Nakusa.
Hometown community spirit. Hometown community pride.
Paper City Savings, a proud sponsor of area sports, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hey, Pointers fans, head out to the Final Score Sports Bar and Grill, watch your favorite teams, and enjoy the daily food and drink specials at the Final Score, 2nd and Maria, Stevens Point.
Halftime, Whitewater 37, UW-Stevens Point 35. Speaking of the Final Score, happy birthday goes out to the owner of the Final Score, Mr. Jim Billings. So must be right around his 40th or so, hopefully. He's going to have a wonderful day. And knowing Jim, it'll be a wonderful day. He always seems to have some fun.
And he's a wonderful man.
Yes, he is.
Truly is.
Great
you know,
family.
And I say that knowing he was born and raised in Iowa. So, when I offer that compliment, it's sincere.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Glad you put that qualifier on. John has all the stats from half one.
That I do, Mr. Krieger. Thank you. For our visitors from Whitewater this evening, by the way, that's the birthplace of my lovely wife, Kelly. Didn't know if you
Whitewater
knew
is?
Yep.
She
lived there early on, and then she and her family moved to Beloit.
She escaped.
Yeah, to Beloit, and she was a Beloit Memorial graduate. In fact, you know this, My wife and I were married by the Beloit Memorial basketball coach, Gene Van Gelder. So every year at NCAA time, we have to renew our vows, or technically, I guess, we're not married anymore. So.
Oh, I didn't know how that
was. That was something Gene wrote into the,
marriage. So you do it every year?
Yeah.
Do you do it in front of yourselves?
The TV.
Oh,
you know,
that worked.
During the first game of the big dance.
Oh, well, very nice.
Like my wife has ever watched a basketball game in her life, right? Although she was a pom-pom at Beloit Memorial. But this all started with stats, so I'll try to get to
back to that.
For the Warhawks, 15 of 32 from the floor. That's 47%. Just one of six from behind the three-point arc. And they were 6 of 8, 75% from the free throw line. They had 19 rebounds in that first, 7 of those on the offensive end. That converted to 8 second chance points. 5 assists to go with 5 turnovers. They had 4 steals and 2 block shots to round out the line. For our pointers in the first half, they finished 12 of 28, 43%. 4 of 9, not too bad, 44% from behind the arc. And after a poor start from the free throw line, we were able to finish 7 of 11, or 63%. As mentioned, we had 15 boards, only 11 on our offensive end. We also had 5 assists to go with 5 turnovers. We had 2 steals and 1 block shots. Points off turnovers, advantage Whitewater 9-7, as I mentioned earlier. Points in the paint, 28-12, advantage the Warhawks. Second chance points, 8-2. Whitewater. Fast break points, 7-4 Whitewater. All these stats going their way. Their bench scoring outscored the pointers 10-8. And finishing this all out, Whitewater used 9 players in their rotation. Stevens point 10. And nobody in immediate foul trouble. A couple guys with 2, nobody with 3.
All right. And scoring wise here for the Warhawks in the opening half, Delvin Barnstable with 8, along with Trayvon Chisholm. You had 6 for Drew Fisher, 5 points for Jameer Barker, 3 apiece for Miles Barnstable and Carter Capstran, and 2 apiece for Elijah Lambert and Will Pitleski. And for Stevens Point, Zach Moots with 10 to lead the way, 8 for Brennan Tim, 6 points at the half for Miles Coleman, 5 for A.J. Mackinnon, and then 2 apiece for Jake Buchanan, Luke Warden, and Elijah Vandervelden. And the pointers trail by 2. Scores that I do have here for you at the moment. These were all close to, if not at halftime. On the men's side, Platteville 32, La Crosse 21. River 41, Stout 32, Eau Claire 25, Oshkosh 20. And again, those were just prior to half for the most part. At the half down in Whitewater, the Warhawks do lead 27 to 25 over our pointer women. So not a bad way to get going for the women down there. Tough place to play. Whitewater in the top 25 right now. So that's obviously a pretty good play at the moment by the pointer women. We're going to take a 90-second break, come back and play the second half of this one. UW-Stevens Point trailing Whitewater 37 to 35. We will be back in 90 seconds. UW-Stevens Point basketball on WPCN.
Hey, sports fans. Scott Glinski of Skyward here. From the court to the field, the ice rink to the putting green, on the track and in the classroom, Skyward supports all local and state athletes. Since 1980, our advanced technology solution has been helping school districts improve outcomes, reduce costs, and achieve success for students. Visit us online at skyward.com to learn more and see how Skyward empowers school districts across Wisconsin. Best of luck to all local sports teams this season.
The UW-Stevens Point men's basketball team is ready to take the lid off the new season with hopes of much better results
You can find out all about this year's team and what to expect on the Pointer Hoops radio show from 6 to 7 Monday night live from Monk's Bar and Grill in Plover. Sponsors include Skyward Incorporated, Hilltop Pub and Grill, Paper City Savings, The Rock and Roll Cafe, Auto Select, and Monk's Bar and Grill. Join Coach Semling and several players Monday night 6 to 7 for the Pointer Hoops radio show on WPCN.
Well, the jackpot snowfall total stayed well to the northwest of us overnight. Our temperature's down to 30 degrees. Some light snows into early Thursday morning. Additional accumulations of around a half inch to an inch. Light snow showers ending Thursday. Storm system winds down over Wisconsin and weakens. High 33. Colder Thursday night down to 15. And then Friday, Saturday, and Sunday feeling more like January, really, with sunshine returning. Highs in the 20s, lows in the teens. I'm meteorologist Scott Lariamore from the Weather Channel.
The final score, Sports Bar and Grill, where you can enjoy a sandwich and your favorite libation at the final score, where Long Island Saturdays turn into bloody Sundays at 2nd and Maria's Stevens Point.
All right, Pointers trail by two as we get ready for the second half. Z, what's got to happen?
Well, just more of the same, Scotty, if we can keep the ball from the rim, especially from the guards. You're going to lose some to this interior line lineup for the Warhawks. They've got some bodies that are a little bit bigger than what we can put out there. Certainly quicker and higher jumpers, but you would like to keep the guards from getting all the way to the rim. Going to have to play some good help and going to have to shoot a good percentage. But that's kind of the story for this Pointer team. We play small, sometimes four guards, and so for us to be successful, we really have got to hit some shots, usually jump shots.
Whitewater will start Barker, Barnstable, Chisholm, and Lambert in the second half. Point goes with Moots, Mackinnon, Tim, Buchanan, and I can't see the fifth.
Did you get Tim?
Elijah? Yep. Okay. All right, Mackinnon inside. Pointers with the basketball. Moots at the free throw line. Gives it back to Jake Buchanan off the Elijah screen. Nowhere to go with it. Kicks it out on top. Tim Moots holds it there against Lambert. To the elbow, pulls up for the jumper and splashes one down.
Well, he's done that repeatedly where he's taken the ball out of defender and has been quick enough to step back and get a shot off.
So we're even at 37 to get this second half started. Whitewater with it. They got it in deep to Chisholm. He missed the bunny. Rebounded by Elijah. Good, strong rebound by Elijah. Up it'll come Buchanan. Runs it to the baseline. Off to Tim. Tim back into the lane. Kick out. Right side Buchanan. Trying to go baseline. Cut off by Barnstable. Back into the hands of Tim. Brennan down on the baseline. Right side into the lane. Left-hander goes up and left it just short.
Love the move. Great ball fake with his and head fake. And just left it short.
Barnstable up. Right wing into the corner. Guarded there by A.J., out to Chisholm, left side to Lambert. We are even at 37 right now. Barnstable off to Chisholm at the arc. Holds it above the head, wants to take it off the dribble against Elijah. Now digging it out is A.J. Mackinnon. Loose ball, Chisholm got it back, then lost it. Into the hands of Vanderbilt, yeah, and off it'll go to Moot.
Yep, Chisholm just held the dribble with his back to the help defense too long.
Mackinnon got by his man in a two-hand push, if you will, by Barnstable. That will be his third foul.
Yeah. If you're trying to back down, you can only hold the ball and dribble so long before the help arrives, and that's what happened. Good job by the Pointers swarming to basketball.
So Barnstable will sit, and J.T. Hoytink will come in. Kid out of Menominee Falls, Sussex Hamilton High.
Our first player with three fouls tonight.
Moots with the basketball. Pointers looking for the lead.
And
going to get a foul. Well, apparently Buchanan ran out of bounds and then was the first to touch after he came back in. So
that was a call.
Turnover.
And they always say when you're official, make that call assertively. And that's exactly what he did. And I'm sure that's exactly what Jake did.
So Barker up front, Hoytink right side. It'll go there to Barnstable. Chance to get the lead, and we didn't. And Chisholm scores
you
inside.
Know what? Yeah. Elijah got caught on a high screen and just wasn't strong enough nor quick enough to recover.
Good offensive play. Left side, it'll go to Moots. 39-37, Whitewater. Mackinnon, right wing, down to the baseline. Cut off by Hoytink. Out it'll go to Brennan Tim. Getting locked up inside. That should be on Chisholm.
It's got to be on one of the two. Just too much contact. You can't allow as an official that much of hand fighting into the post, or it just turns into a wrestling match.
Well, you go from a 6'8 Elijah Vandervelden down to a 6-foot Ryan Genrick, but that's our rotation right now. Inbound Tim, back it'll go, Mooch back to Tim in the block. Left-hander spins, gives to a cutter, Buchanan lays it in. We're tied.
Jake always moving and made himself available for
39 apiece. 17:26 to go. Barker over to Hoyting. Whitewater tied up with the pointers. Barker at the top of the circle. Barnstable to the lane. Puts up a short jumper. Left it short. Rebound. Whitewater underneath again. How? Hoyting goes up with the shot. Got He'll score it. A foul.
And Hoyting was probably the smallest guy in that whole mess. And he's the one that came out of it.
Just don't box out. He came in off the wing. He didn't keep him out there.
He came in with a little momentum, so he got up a little higher perhaps. But boy, you work so hard to force a miss, and then you don't end the possession, the defensive possession, with a rebound.
And by the way, the foul on Buchanan, he'll sit right back down. Hoytink with a three-point play.
What an interesting shot, doesn't he? Kind of shoots from the hip, but
42-39, Whitewater now. Miles Coleman on the wing. Into the lane, pulls up for the short jumper, left it short, rebound, Whitewater. They crash the glass. The pointers rarely get more than two guys in trying to rebound. Barker off, it'll go on top to Hoytink. He's been a problem. Hoytink has, he'll take it in, blocked away by Genrick. Saved from going out of bounds by Ryan, but picked up in Whitewater, will get it to Barnstable. And he is fouled underneath.
Boy, another one of those 50-50 balls, we get to all of them.
Foul gonna go on Miles Coleman.
We just really need that consistent post player. We've got some in.
We need some 6'4", 6'5", guys that rebound and are wider bodies than, if you will, the bean poles.
Well, that's
nothing wrong with those guys.
No, it's the danger.
They get bumped
when you
around.
Play with all the guards, Scotty, as you give up rebounding. I tell you what. Offensive rebounds tonight have been the story of this game.
Well, now you're down by five on chances that you should have been getting loose balls and rebounds.
Yep.
Mackinnon into the front court, sends it over to Tarjan, who is back in. Handoff pass from Tim to Genrick, back underneath. Tim can't hit it, trying to get it back, loses the basketball. Off to Barker into the front court, heads left, and throws it away.
Yeah, there he is. Didn't connect, lack of communication.
Brennan Tim got it in deep, but then didn't know how to get a shot up over the defender. Ended up putting it up too hard.
Well,
it's a five-point game.
Basket, down five.
That's for sure. You can't let this thing extend again. Ryan down the left of the lane. Doesn't go for the shot. Kick out will go to Brennan Tim. Brennan into the lane, down the lane.
Boy,
he is fouled going in.
Look, that was a great attack. Good first step, good explosive move. Looked like they were going to do the handoff, and he did not give the ball up and exploded.
And we've got the media timeout. 15:59 to go. 44-39 Whitewater. We're back in 1 minute. Pointers basketball on WPCN. It's a road game for the Spash Boys basketball team Friday, playing at Merrill. Hear the game at 7 o'clock on True Oldies, 92.1 FM, 1010 AM, WPCN. On the internet at 921WPCN.com or on the TuneIn Radio app. Sponsored by Hilltop Pub and Grill. For lunch or dinner, the Hilltop is there for you. For dine-in, carry-out, or delivery, open daily at 11. Paper City Savings, great rates for all your financial needs. Online at PaperCitySavings.com. Made of custom apparel and sporting goods. Whether you're on the field or in the office, let our team outfit your team. Lee Ayers Jewelers, providing custom design jewelry and free custom design consultations, as well as jewelry repair where dreams are made. Pizza Ranch in Plover, great pizza and chicken, open daily at 11. Eagle Carpet and Upholstery Cleaning, doing commercial, residential, and rentals. Call Jay at 345-1005. And Second Street Auto Center, your complete auto care center across from the final score. Second and Maria, Stevens Point, Spash Boys Basketball Friday on WPCN.
Monk's Bar and Grill, celebrating 75 years of food and fun.
Monk's Bar and Grill is a proud supporter of UW Stevens Point basketball, located at Crossroad Commons, Plover.
All right, 16 minutes to go here, and Stevens Point down 5, 44-39. It was a two-point game at the half. Brennan Tim will be at the line, though, to try to get his team 2 points closer.
Yep, we were tied at 39. Whitewater on a small run here, 5-0. And that ends that.
Brennan hits that. He has 9 points in the game.
Second chance point, Scotty, is now 13-2 in favor of Whitewater. We're down 3 and have been outscored by 11 on second chance opportunities.
3-point game. Tim made them both. He has 10 points in the ball game. Hoytink into the front court. Lambert on the right wing. Looked into the post. Doesn't throw it there. Up on top to Barker. Guarded by Tarjan. Pull up jumper and he splashed one down.
That was sweet, Scotty. He really showed that he was going left-handed, of course, to his left, and he pulled back that dribble.
46-41. Down to the baseline. Genrich fumbles it, picked up by Lambert. Lambert into the front court, brings the dribble over to the right side. They only gave him a 2 on that one, Barker. Into the left corner it will go. Pull up jumper, splash, 3 down.
Got a 3 on
for
that
Barnes Stable. Starting to get away from you
down
again.
8. I think that's the biggest lead tonight, isn't it?
Well, we had an 8-point lead at 18-10.
Yep, and 22-14.
Over to the right side, it'll go to Brennan Tim. Locked down on the baseline with Capstrand. Takes him into the lane. A little spin move, lays it up and in.
Well, he's showing a little bit more assertiveness tonight, a little more confidence by Brennan Tim. He's got a lot of skills, and he's starting to find his way.
49-43, Hoytink off on the right side to Barnstable. Holds it, bounces it into the lane, poked away, Capstrand with it. Kick out Hoytink, trying to get by Mackinnon down to the baseline. Pushing his way in, and now a foul.
I think he might have stepped out of bounds, Scotty.
Well,
it's the other end of the court from us.
By anybody, yeah.
I think he was working against AJ one-on-one down towards the right blocks and just stepped out of bounds on the baseline.
You are correct. 6-point lead. Pointers will have the ball back here.
Well, here's a chance. You gotta finally got to stop.
Genrich will bring it up here. Works against Lambert on the dribble over to the right side. Ryan. Crossover down to the baseline. Gets it off inside. Luke Warden, little hesitation, double clutch,
like
and goes
Luke
up and scores.
The freshman, Scott. He took the ball into the contact, so he knew where that defender was.
Yep. Front court, pointers back within 4. Hoytink pinned down by Mackinnon, gets rid of it. Capstrand right back to Hoytink. Takes it over the top of the screen there. Off to Barker, wants another 3, and got another one.
Boy, got back-to-back 3 for Barker.
Up it'll come. Moots down to the left or right block.
Foul.
And a foul is going to go on Barker. That is going to be his second, I believe. Third to fourth now on the Warhawks, pardon me.
Because Barker played for some really good St. Catharines teams.
Yeah, that's a fact. State champs.
And help me out. The kid down at Texas now started at Iowa State.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about. But
what a great player.
Inbound to Warden on the right baseline. Working against Chisholm. Gives it off to Moots. Zach, no shot available. AJ right back over to Moots. Down to the baseline. Step back jumper. Got it.
Well, you can't keep trading baskets, however.
Nope.
At some point, you got to put some stops together, and that's been difficult tonight.
52-47. Lambert on the left wing for Whitewater. Right side, it'll go. Barnstable into the post. Ball tipped away, picked up by the pointer.
Good play by Zach Moots. Overplay.
Zach into the front court, top of the circle, into the lane underneath. It'll go to Warden. Missed the layup. Kicked it out. Genrich on top to Tarjan. A runner down the lane. Tried to bank it. No. Loose ball. Moots in trouble. Got rid of it. Off to AJ. Kick out there. Around it'll go to Moots. Lift the 3. Got it.
Wow, what a possession. Maybe
finally
best
some
possession.
Second chance points.
On our own. Somebody slapped the board when Luke Warden was going
for
that layup.
Goaltending,
well,
not?
I don't know who slapped it. I thought their defender did.
Hoytink over the top of the circle. Back out. Lambert wants 3. Left it short. Headed to the out of bounds, and it will go there. It'll be back to Stevens Point. Auto Select, quality, dependable auto repair and service performed by qualified technicians you can trust. Pointers are down 2, 12:42 to go in the ball game. Pointers will bring it up here. They've had to go almost the entire game without Jake Buchanan. Genrich runs left baseline into the lane to Warden. He'll let it up and in with a foul. He went up against their bigger guy and scored it. The freshman with a nice basket.
Green Bay, and he's showing why he was
builder.
Shows why he was such a coveted recruit. Green Bay, Notre Dame.
That is the fourth now on Trevon Chisholm. That is going to bring back Will Pitleski.
Scotty, Therese Hunter.
Yes,
is the young man from Racine St. Cat's that I was trying to come up with.
You did good coming up with it, by the way.
Well, I come up with things at my age, just not as quickly as I used to.
At least you come up with them. Warden's free throw left it short, unfortunately.
Nice spark off the bench.
But we are tied. We are tied back up at 52.
Luke, you were asking about 6'4", 6'5", 6'6", guys. Luke Warden, of course, is at 6'6", and he just got picked off at the top.
Yeah.
These guys are just kind of screeners on the free throw line, and then they dive, and we haven't gone with them.
Yeah,
and
Pitleski got right to the basket and scored out without any trouble. Genrich into the lane, spin move, back and down, double clutch, goes up, and he scores it. Brian.
A lot of really good individual moves tonight.
54 apiece. Left side, Whitewater with the ball. Back on top and over it'll go. Tipped away underneath, but it'll go back to Whitewater off the pass from Fisher. Oh,
good job of Zach anticipating where that play was going to go. He took a different route than the man he was defending, but he got there just in time.
Final score, Sports Bar and Grill scoreboard shows the Pointers locked up with Whitewater at 54 inbound. Barker open on the baseline score.
Yeah, came off a screen by Miles Barnstable. Simple set play, but we got picked off.
Mackin in front court, back down by two. AJ runs baseline, goes right to the rack and scores.
Showed some quickness there, didn't he? AJ's having such a good year.
56 apiece. Working dribble, Barnstable kicks to the corner. Fisher back on top, Pitleski over to the left side, Barnstable. Working down the left of the lane, kicks on the wing, jumper on the way, off the rim, no, tipped by Genrich, tipped again. Fisher comes down with it, scores it, and a foul. And you just can't believe how many times you can't get a rebound.
Yeah, that one came up high and long, but, you know, a number of cases, Scotty, we're just unable to get up to the ball with Whitewater. They're just jumping higher than we are.
Well, the basket good by Fisher.
Once again, offensive rebounding has been the best weapon for the Warhawks so far tonight.
Free throw, and it's back to a three-point lead for the Warhawks.
Boy,
you work so hard, and then it all falls apart because you can't get a rebound. 59-56, A.J. Mackinnon takes it to the lane. Got a lot of bump, nothing called. Out, it'll go to Tarjan.
You know, we should say it's not for a lack of effort.
No,
they're just bigger, stronger bodies, and we're unable to get up to the rebound.
Warden backdoor cut. Genrich missed the bunny.
Came in hard off the baseline. Perfect pass from Warden, and he just underlaid it.
59-56, Whitewater. Things you can't have happen when you want to win big games. Into the corner, it'll go to Barnstable, working against Moots. Barker to the left elbow. Hands it back. Fisher down the lane, falling down, almost got it to go, then got his own rebound, and luckily for Point, lost the handle and out of bounds.
Well, they're battling both ways, I'll tell you that. 10:26 to go here.
Coleman's going to come in for Moots. Three-point Whitewater lead, 10:26 to go in the ball game.
We were 37-35 at half Whitewater by two, so they've kind of played even.
Mackinnon, front court Pointers. Across the way, it'll come to Genrich. Tarjan on the right side, takes the dribble to the top of the circle. Gives right side, catch, shoot, Mackinnon three, rims out long. Saved by Coleman.
Well, what a play by Miles
Fisher.
Yep,
and out of bounds.
Yep, that was a heady play. Tough shot by A.J. Mackinnon on that. He came off a down pick. And when you're coming hard up the court and have to catch, turn and shoot in one motion.
Well, Buchanan comes back in, John, with 10:03 to go. He'll get the ball inbounds on the left baseline off to Luke Warden. Little bodied up, goes up and scores it in the lane.
Luke likes physical contact before he shoots. He's consistently just taking the ball in until he gets that hit and then raises and gets the little half hook.
Warhawks by one, Barnstable to Barker. Genrich fights through the screen. Barker down the left of the lane, bounces it underneath. They'll get it off and bank it in for Fisher again.
Yeah. More
sophomore
more points.
Fisher out of Oconomowoc.
Yeah, more points in the paint.
11 points in the game for Fisher. Buchanan into the lane. Pull up short jumper, and he got it.
That's a good move by Jake, knowing if he went all the way to the rim, he was going to get smothered, stopped, and hit the little six-footer.
61-60, Fisher again. Takes it right to the basket and draws a foul. How is he getting by his guy so easy?
Yeah, and that's the challenge, is that on-ball defense. Is you have to at least stay between your man and the basket, right? That's about as fundamental as you get. That starts at the earliest levels. And sometimes the other guy is coming off a screen or gives you a fake, or he's just playing quicker than you are, and they get around you.
Free throw is good.
But I'll tell you, if you let your responsibility get around you that easily, the whole defense falls apart.
Fisher averages 5'5", and he now has 13 in the ballgame. Yep.
Having a game.
It's killing you.
Yep.
63-60.
Sophomore guard, as you mentioned, Scotty, from Oconomowoc.
On top to Buchanan. Down the left of the lane. Kicks to the corner. Back out around it'll come. Miles Coleman with it for Stevens Point. Off the Warden screen.
Oh, he missed him.
Oh, he had Luke wide open. Finally got it to him, but a little too late.
Yeah, they're going to get a foul on that, Scotty, but he had Luke Ward wide. Both guys stayed with the ball on that ball screen, that high ball screen. Luke did the pick and roll, and he was wide, wide open. I don't think you'd get any more open on a pick and roll.
Pitleski with the foul, 6 on Whitewater now. Keep that in mind. Coleman to the circle, into the lane, pulls up from 14 and hit it.
Well, kind of the same play, but instead of going right, he went off the screen left and hit the jumper.
Back within one once again. Can you get a stop? 8.5 minutes to go here. Barker off the high screen. Genrich fights over the top. Barnstable in the right corner. Back to Barker. Barnstable into the lane. Down the lane against Mile. Backdoor cut again. Fisher. Yeah. Score and a layup. And how and
well,
how
that was
and how.
Jake Buchanan got caught thinking he was going to come in and help. And as he took two steps towards the ball, his responsibility, who was Drew Fisher, just did a hard back cut and was wide open.
Well, now a chance to make it a 4-point lead, and he gets the free throw to go. Yeah. He's killing you.
He's having a
Drew
heck of a game.
Fisher.
You just never know who's going to step up, do you?
66-62. And a foul on the wing on Barnstable. Well, that is now 7 on the Warhawks, so you're going to shoot. And in a game like this, you better make them.
Well,
front end of a 1-1.
I know who's ever guarding Drew Fisher might not want to do a whole lot of helping. Not, at least not early help off of him, because he's really been effective. If you leave me or turn your head and I'm going to cut.
Zach misses the front end.
Tough free throw tonight.
Well, you're down 4, and you've had so many chances here.
He's now 2 of 6, Scotty.
Yep. Unstable out at the timeline. Runs into a pick, and a foul.
Yeah, I got hands. Yep.
Buchanan will get his 4th. Not a good night for Jake.
No.
Wow. Team number 6 on Stevens Point now.
Jake has yet to log in 10 minutes even, Scotty.
Yep.
So
he's going inbound to Hoyting.
Spend 75% of this game on the bench.
Down the lane against A.J. Mackinnon. Missed the shot, but of course tipped out. Who? Fisher. Into the lane. He'll go right to the rack. Missed the bunny. And the rebound picked up by Whitewater. How, I don't know, because there were 4 pointers there. They couldn't find the handle. Barker with it. Over to the right corner. It'll go there. Barnstable with it. 7.5 minutes to go in the ball game. Barker down the left of the lane. Pull up jumper. Missed that one. It goes underneath. Hoyting, pardon me, Pitleski. Off the rim, no. Rebound, Whitewater. Tipped away. Loose ball.
And a jump ball.
I don't think that should have been called.
I think that.
We're lucky on that one.
We're lucky on that one.
Joey Berezowitz out of Burlington, 5'10 freshman, will come in for the Warhawks. Possession arrow, unfortunately, for the pointers in favor of the Warhawks. 7:24 to go, And another timeout. Warhawks 66, Pointer 62. Pointer basketball on WPCN.
Hey, sports fans. Scott Glinski of Skyward here. From the court to the field, the ice rink to the putting green, on the track and in the classroom, Skyward supports all local and state athletes. Since 1980, our advanced technology solution has been helping school districts improve outcomes, reduce costs, and achieve success for students. Visit us online at skyward.com to learn more and see how Skyward empowers school districts across Wisconsin. Best of luck to all local sports teams this season.
The UW-Stevens Point men's basketball team is ready to take the lid off the new season with hopes of much better results. You can find out all about this year's team and what to expect on the Pointer Hoops radio show from 6 to 7 Monday night live from Monk's Bar and Grill in Plover. Sponsors include Skyward Incorporated, Hilltop Pub and Grill, Paper City Savings, The Rock and Roll Cafe, Auto Select, and Monk's Bar and Grill. Join Coach Semling and several players Monday night 6 to 7 for the Pointer Hoops radio show on WPCN.
7:24 to go in the ballgame, John, and still in it, but boy, oh boy, the opportunities that you've had to just be down four, it's a shame.
And it's all on the glass, Scotty. We're down 11 now, total rebounds, 32-21, but we have given up 14 offensive boards against a team that's shooting 48%, so if you give up 14, you make half of them, right? Seven? That's 14 points on second chance. Actually, official stats, 16.
Yep.
And that just doesn't get it done when you give teams 16 extra points.
All right, Warhawks are going to inbound off the baseline here. Fisher, the inbounder, gets it into the right corner. Out on top to Barker. It worked with a 20-second shot clock. Barker right down the lane, scooping layup, and he got it.
Tough. They actually changed that from the right hand to the left hand in traffic. It's a heck of a finish. I do not think I'd like to play him one-on-one.
68-62, moots into the lane. That was a pretty good body check by Barker. No whistle. Tim on the wing, hand off to Mackinnon. A.J. trying to go baseline, got it into Brennan. He'll score it.
But we're in the same boat, Scotty. Can we get a rebound?
We give that much effort. Over to the right side, Fisher. Gus Foster getting set to come in. It'll go left side, Barnstable. Barker off on the right side, Pitleski. Lobs down low, tipped away and stolen away by Brennan Tim. Good job by Brennan. Need a basket. Kendrick up front, gives to the corner. Miles Coleman into the lane. Jump stop, short jumper, he got it.
Good attack.
Miles very capable. He has 10 points.
Seems like Whitewater might start to open that gap. Here we come back.
Right back within two. Can he get a stop? Over to the right side, Fisher. 6:10 to go in the ballgame. Barker at the arc. Takes it against Ryan Genrick. Working off the dribble. Left side, it'll go Berezowitz. Berezowitz into the lane, down the lane. Jump stop, kick out. Fisher, here he comes again. Stolen away by Coleman, and then falling to the floor, Barnstable. Back to Fisher, down the lane, a score. And what are we going to get?
Yeah, the shot clock got reset, and it should have never reset.
Well, we got a break there.
Now it's down to three. Well, it's not really a
break.
Well,
it is a break because Fisher just hit a shot.
Right, but...
And if they don't call that, you're two more points down.
That's true. It's a break for sure.
Okay.
And they only have 3 seconds left, so...
Yeah, okay.
But, and it's our...
I was blocked out again, but it looked like you got cut off.
We did. Actually, you got undercut.
How is that not a foul?
Well, you tell me. Miles was going to take that ball on a steal, and I don't know which player it was.
I thought
maybe Barnstable or Fisher went down the floor and took his legs out, and in the melee, the officials just didn't call anything.
Whitewater to inbound. They lob it toward the rim, tipped away Brennan Tim. He's got Genrick out front, didn't get him to him right away, but Ryan holds back and then scores it. We're tied.
They hung in the air a long time on that and was able to get the left-hander to go. If he shoots that right-handed, Scotty, it gets blocked.
It is Whitewater on the wing. This is Fisher. Barker, left side, Barnstable, got by Zach. Down to the baseline, lost it off his foot. Picked up by Tim. Brennan's going to start it up the floor. Gets it back to Zach Moots. Chance to get the lead.
This is getting wild.
Yeah. Mackinnon into the front court. These players are playing so hard.
Both teams.
You know, I'm complaining, but they're playing hard. Mackinnon to a cutting. Tim down the lane, can't hit the shot. A lot of contact, no whistle. Off it'll go to Fisher. Fisher to Barker into the front court. Whitewater with the ball, tied game. Barker on the wing off the screen by Pitleski, got it back to him, and he'll pick and roll score.
He's coming up on that high ball screen, and then it gets rejected, and he dives to the basket, and we don't dive with him.
That's just a well-constructed offense, simple, but boy, the timing on that is so important, and they time it out beautifully. Yeah. Our bigs just are having a hard time. They see that high ball screen, and that's what their intention is, and then that dive to the basket, and we're just not ready for it.
Final score, Sports Bar and Grill. Watch your favorite teams enjoy the daily food and drink specials at the final score. Second of Maria Stevens Point. So the Pointers battle back six in a row to tie it. And right away, the Warhawks go and untie it. It's 70-68. Pointers will have the basketball.
Both teams will shoot from this juncture out. 16 fouls for Stevens Point, 7 for Whitewater. Nobody's in timeout troubles at all. Six. The Pointers have their 6 left. Whitewater has 5 left. So, you got to within 2 with 5 minutes to go, Scotty. And now it's anybody's game.
Well, you brought Gus Foster in, a little bit bigger guy at 6'3". He hasn't had much playing time. Sets a screen out on the left side. Mackinnon with the ball. A.J. out to Gus. Over to the right side. It'll go there to Moots. Moots, a handoff pass will go to Genrich. Genrich back to the top of the circle, looking at Tim. Down the left of the lane. Kick out. Mackinnon into the corner. Gives back out. Ryan thought about it. Takes it into the lane. Down the lane. A little tough. Left-hander, no. Tipped around. Loose. Kicked out and picked up there by Barnstable. Who had it tipped away. Brennan Tim comes out of there with it. Jump ball. They still didn't call it. And Whitewater gets it back. Now he gets a takedown. Wow, after all of that, you're going to finally call a foul. There were bodies flying everywhere. You should have had a foul called earlier. You didn't get it. Just unbelievable.
Wow, it was wild.
After
for sure.
all of that... Yep. To get a foul called.
It looked like Brennan Tim was going to get that steal and give Whitewater credit. They won't let him corral it. You know, the interesting thing about that call, though, Scott, is the guy that made the call was the only
on
official
the other side
on
of the
complete other side of the floor. Yeah. The two guys here were letting the play continue, and the guy comes charging
hate
in
to watch that
from probably 40 feet away.
You hate to watch that. It just changes the game. Barker makes the free throw. The foul was called on Brennan Tim, who quite frankly should have been in a tie-up, and the Pointers would have had the ball. Now it's a 4-point Whitewater lead.
That certainly didn't go our way there, did it?
No. That was the first time I really think you got abused by the officials with their lack of ability to call the game. Down low, it'll go to Brennan Tim. Into the paint. In trouble, kicks it around. Foster, out it'll go to Genrich. Across the way to A.J. Mackinnon. Thought about a three, gives it back to Moots, almost turned it over. Zach, 6 on the shot clock, into the lane, turnaround jumper, not gonna go. Rebound, Whitewater. Boy, you get yourself all the way back, and then you
let
him
squirt out again. And they've done a good job of making us one and done, and we have not been able to return the favor as Whitewater continues to get.
Fisher, Barker down the lane, blocked. Loose ball picked up by A.J. He's going to bring it up against Barnstable.
Oh, he got fouled.
Takes it down the lane and is finally a whistle called that time.
Yeah, good
Didn't
job.
Get the shot.
By A.J. of drawing that foul, really. He was running even with the defender and leaned into him, so the official had to see the contact.
That is the fifth on Barnstable.
Uh-huh. Take an early exit tonight. Yeah.
Averages 14-1. He'll leave the game with 3 points tonight, but he was in foul trouble all night long.
Mr. Fisher has picked up that slack, though, hasn't he?
He has. And then some, right?
Yep.
A.J. needs to make free throws. The last time you were there, you missed the front end. This should be a two-shot foul.
It is.
4-point ball game, 3:29 to go. A.J.'s free throw on the way. Unbelievable.
Boy. Now 9 of 16, the Pointers. That's 7 we've left on the charity stripe, down 4. You can do the math.
This one on the way for A.J. Got one out of the two. Better than none, as John said before. 3-point ball game, 3:27 to go.
Whitewater, by the way, 15 of 17 from the foul line. That's pretty good.
Into the right corner from Hoyting, inside off the hand of Chisholm. They're going to say that it's off a pointer hand.
Yeah, our players reacted as if they thought Chisholm hit it last, but tell you what, from where I'm sitting, your guess is as good as mine.
Inbounder, Whitewater off the baseline, into the corner, it'll go. Had a 20-second shot clock. Left corner, running baseline, right, Fisher, foul. And there's a foul on Foster.
Well, that's our eighth team foul. Now Foster's got to go to the line to shoot a bonus.
Fisher.
Fisher, where he is.
Perfect.
65% free throw shooter.
4-4 tonight.
He's kind of having a game of his life here, isn't he? He's done very little wrong, I'll tell you that.
72-69, 3:11 to go here. So many chances. It's just frustrating because you want this young team to get a big win, and they just can't get the play they need to get over the hump.
Yeah, that's been the case, hasn't it? And we've had a lot of these games this year.
Yeah, for sure. This one, both good. 5-point Whitewater lead. 74-69.
Yeah, they're not looking for a moral victory.
No, nope, there is no such thing. Buchanan, kick out Tim. You need a basket, to say the least. A.J. Mackinnon in on the right side. It'll go to Zach Moots. Into the lane, kicks to the corner. Tim runs baseline, goes reverse, got it to go. Brennan's having a pretty good game.
You know what? Brennan's having a great game.
Pointers have 6 timeouts.
Coach is asking for one.
Well, the ball was rolling. You can't let too many seconds tick off. Now coach is going to get a timeout.
Yeah, he called for one early. At least I heard it through the headset.
I don't think you get paid for taking, you know, timeouts to the locker room at the end of the game.
You can't carry them over and invest them, right?
No.
So
better use some of them.
And you know what? It's nothing else. As hard as the guys are playing and you got a big defensive stand coming up, it allows them to get a drink of water and rest a little bit.
74-71, Whitewater, 2:50 to go in the basketball game.
Well, Whitewater 27-55 for the game. That's 49%. Pointers 28-54, clipping around at 52%. But boy, it's just 14 rebounds we've given up on Whitewater's offensive end.
Well, and Whitewater has missed 2 free throws. If you had only missed 2 free throws, you would actually have a 2-point lead.
Well, we talk about it all the time, about half the games over the course of the season at any level are determined at the free throw line. Yep. One of the first books I read when I got so interested in basketball was a book by John Wooden, and that's something that stuck with me at that early age, something he wrote in there. Like, he said something like 50-whatever% of games are won at the free throw line or lost. And, of course, the notion there is if you never miss one, right? And I don't know that I've seen too many teams never miss one. But
it is an uncontested shot.
Yeah.
You should make a high percentage.
I mean, the one that stands out to you is Zach Moots. So he's a 74% free throw shooter, and he's just 2 of 6 tonight. Not sure what's going through his rhythm, but a lot of those haven't been close.
Final score, Sports Bar and Grill scoreboard showing the Pointers down 74-71, Whitewater with the ball. Hoytink off to Fisher on the right side. They've been killers here tonight for the Hawks. Taking it on the dribble, Fisher bounces it out. Barker into the lane. Came to a jump stop, and an offensive foul is going to be called on Jameer Barker.
Yeah, and a really, really nice play by Foster, Scotty. Who read that play early and got to a spot and waited. Barker just made the mistake of taking one dribble too deep.
So the Pointers get it back down 3. Jake Buchanan in, Foster back out. A little offensive-defensive switch.
Yep.
Can we get Jake a shot? Hoytink on the guard. Takes it down to the baseline. Comes to a stop. Lobs it all the way out to Moots, who wants a 3. Left it short. Hoytink with a rebound.
Yep. Running out of possession. Still a lot of time left, 2:12.
Barker, right side pass, will go there. Barnstable with it. Gives to Barker back in the right corner. Chisholm across the way, left side, Fisher. Fisher, 14 on the clock against Mackinnon, much bigger than A.J., takes him down into the post. Scooping layup, missed it. Tipped by Genrich, into the corner, out of bounds. Whitewater ball.
And yet another, we... You see him attacking, you, It's almost got to be all hands on deck. We had some guys on the wing just watch that,
yep,
who I thought could have got to that ball.
Chisholm, Hoytink, into the lane, up over Buchanan and hit it.
Well, and they're going after.
Just killing it.
Yeah, they said, let's go after the guy with four fouls.
Yep. All right, you're back down by five again, a minute 40 to go. Genrich bounces it off to Brennan Timp. Takes it into the lane, need a basket, jump stop, kicks it out on the perimeter. Genrich with it. Working a lot of dribble, not much action. It'll go to Buchanan. Free throw line into the lane, turnaround jumper, got it.
Well, he had to create his own shot. It was well defended, but that's something we've seen Jake do since he's been with us.
Well, he'll take another timeout here with a minute 22 to go. Clock really flies when you're trailing.
Yeah, doesn't it? I think that's what was that guy's name, Einstein or something, that talked about relativity?
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
Minute 22
when you're,
to go.
When you're losing, time goes a whole different speed.
76-73. Hilltop Pub and Grill for lunch or dinner. The Hilltop is there for you. Dine in, carry out, or delivery. Open daily at 11. No game tomorrow. On the road at Merrill on Friday night. And then back right here, a 5 o'clock afternoon game against La Crosse coming up for the Pointers on Saturday afternoon. And by the way, we'll also have the Pointer women's game. A.J. Ligman will have that from La Crosse. They get underway at 3. Well, can you get a stop again? And well, you're going to need several stops if you're going to win this game, to say
well,
the least.
Well, you are. And again, we talk about all the time. A defensive possession, no matter how hard you play, doesn't end until you get and secure
get the ball
rebound. And that's what ends, you know, that's what creates a stop, is great defense, and then you get the rebound. And we just haven't been able to do that final piece to the defensive puzzle.
You know, that last one you were talking about when Whitewater shot, you had Fisher kind of force one
yeah,
up.
He did.
It looked like, oh, we'll get the rebound, and nobody went to get the ball. And then Genrich had a scramble coming in right off the wing and couldn't control
it. That was nearly going to be an air ball. It got just enough of that rim that Fisher was able to bother the rebound. Otherwise, Ryan was going to get an easy rebound. But all that time, we had a couple guys out 25 feet away that never moved.
Boy, Tink has it up on top. We're down to the final minute and a half. Barnstable, Pointers down 3. Hoytink right side. Skip pass over the top into the corner. It'll go Fisher into the lane. Picked it back up. I don't know how that's not a double dribble. I guess they'll say he lost it. Chisholm, a huge three
from
the left corner.
Wouldn't you know, they hit that three off of that play. They're going to, I'm sure the official construed that as what's called a fumble.
Yeah.
And if you fumble the ball, you're allowed to retrieve it. And you know what? From my angle, that's what I think was the proper call.
Probably then. All right, 56 seconds to go. That's a huge three by Chisholm. Point's going to take a timeout. He wants to get the offensive substitution.
Jake was going to have to stay off the floor. Jake,
you still got plenty of timeouts.
You do.
So.
But now, what was a three-point lead that you were flirting with, now it's 6. And that makes it so much harder.
Well, the effort by these guys, we can't fault. I know I sound like I'm complaining. I'm not complaining as in lack of effort. I'm complaining as in, darn it, that's my team, and we just can't get what we need to get over the hump.
And does it seem that we're just one player away, Scotty?
Well,
and we're talking about that a post player. We're talking about 6'5", 6'6". I thought Luke Ward was showing some real good play. We haven't seen him for a while. Maybe got lost in the bench or in the rotation. But you know, Luke was the big guy that was actually playing pretty well out there. And he's 6'6", just a freshman. But Luke's going to be a really good player for the Pointers.
Yep, I agree with you there.
There'll be a time when you're not going to be able to get him off the floor. And of course, we've also got Van Kelster, a great freshman from Freedom. He tweaked an ACL. It doesn't appear that he's going to need surgery, but he needs time for it to heal. And so far, We don't know when that's going to be.
All right, 57 seconds. Inbound, it'll come to Buchanan. You're down six off to Mackinnon.
You don't need a three, but nope, you need an early score.
But you do need a basket. Mackinnon over to the right side, working on the dribble. Takes it to the lane, backing his way in to the free throw line. Moots will lift a three, and he got it. What a shot by Zach.
That's the biggest shot of the night.
79-76, three-point game. You need to stop. Game clock 38, shot clock 26. So 12-second difference if you can get a stop. He'll get it inside to Barker against Genrich. Kicks to the corner. I thought he'd get a shot up. Yep. He did not take it. Into the post and a foul.
But you know what? You can only hope at this point at 27.6 seconds that we can get lucky enough that they missed the front end of a bonus. Because this is not a two-shot foul.
Chisholm, but 4 of 4 from the stripe tonight.
Yep, and as a team, again, they're 17 of 19.
Yep. So they've difference been, in the game, in a sense, right there.
That and
front end of the 1-1. He missed it, as you asked for. Here's your chance.
Yep.
Shot clock off. A three ball would tie it. Genrich off to A.J. Mackinnon. They'll get it into the hands of Jake Buchanan. Buchanan trying to work off a screen, going left, back up on top. A.J. into the lane, down the lane, kicks it out. Genrich won't take the three. Gives it back to A.J. Down to 8 seconds. Looking for some help. Over to Genrich. He's going to lift the three. Off the rim, no. Brennan Tim gets it to Buchanan. Shot at the horn. No. And the pointers fail tonight, but a great effort.
We had a chance to tie in our hands, not once, but twice. And, you know, I almost wondered if we would just attack, get the layup, get it within one, and then see if we get into foul situation. But you know what? Give Whitewater credit. They knew we needed a three, and they defended that arc really well.
Yep. Whitewater will win it here tonight by a final of 79-76. Great effort by the pointers. And as John said before, no moral victory. It's going to hurt. You've got to rebound somehow and come back. And that will be on Saturday afternoon. Let's take a two-minute break. And we'll come right back. UW Stevens Point basketball on WPCN.
It's a college basketball doubleheader on Saturday when the UW Stevens Point women and men both face lacrosse. Hear both games starting at 2:45 on True Oldies, 92.1 FM, 1010 AM, WPCN, on the internet at 921WPCN.com or on the TuneIn radio app. Sponsored by Skyward Incorporated, connecting parents and education. Hilltop Pub and Grill for lunch or dinner. The Hilltop is there for you for dine-in, carry-out, or delivery. Open daily at 11. Paper City Savings, a proud supporter of our community with locations in Plover, Wisconsin Rapids, and Nakusa. The Rock and Roll Cafe, open 7 days a week. Step in for breakfast or lunch at Stanley and Minnesota Stevens Point. And Auto Select, quality, dependable auto repair and service performed by qualified technicians you can trust. That's UW Stevens Point, men's and women's basketball against lacrosse.